Visual Studio 2010 is the most powerful and advanced editor Microsoft has released to developers so far. This presentation should make you comfortable when using the core features of Visual Studio 2010 right away. Okay. The new features are useful when writing the code, understanding the code, when navigating through code, when debugging the code, or even when you publish your code. Visual Studio 2010 makes your life easier. The Visual Studio shell has been completely rewritten in WPF now. It uses the power of XAML, making it easy to customize. WPF usage adds a lot of possibilities to the editor. Also, there are slight enhancements in the colors of the windows, text, and the visuals. You'll see that. Visual Studio 2010 provides a long list of new features. You can see many of them here in the list. I will not be able to cover each and everything in this video. Rather, I'll try to cover the ones which I think are most important to developers and mostly the ones which are my favorites. You can always refer to Microsoft documentation if you think I did not cover something important. First things first, on the start page of the Visual Studio, at the left, you can see a list of recent projects you worked on. Now, what's special there is, you can make a project in the list fixed by pinning it. I know how important it can be. When we work on many projects, we don't want to remember the locations of the projects and open them manually. This feature definitely helps. Few other improvements in the editor are, like we can target our application to any .NET framework like 2.0, 3.0, 3.5 and 4.0 when creating a project. As Visual Studio 2010 comes with an ability to create many types of projects, it also comes with search capabilities for finding the right templates. You can search for the templates and start using them. Let's see these three features. I have opened up the Visual Editor. Here, on the left side, you are seeing recent projects list. As and when you start creating new projects, after a few days, the list grows, becomes lengthy, and makes it difficult for you to identify and open a previous project. Understanding our concern, Microsoft has given an option to pin the projects. Here it is. Now, this project sticks and stays in the same place even if we create new projects. As I said earlier, WPF adds a lot of capabilities. How many times you wanted to browse to the project root folder in Windows Explorer? It was very difficult earlier as we used to locate the projects manually and open the root folders. Not anymore, just right click on the project. We have an option here to open the containing folder. Even when we wanted to remove a project from the recent list, there was no option earlier, which made us to get worried and start doing all wrong things with the registry in an attempt to remove them. Now, we have this option too on the right-click context menu. I can remove the unwanted projects from the list. To demonstrate one more feature, let me try to create a project. In this dialog, you can see we have search functionality. Let me try some keyword here, WCF. You can see now the list of project templates that matches the keyword is displayed. We can start using it. Interesting, right? Let's go back and see few UI related features. Firstly, zoom inside using control and mouse wheel. All the developers don't want to see the code in same size. In the earlier versions, when you wanted to increase or decrease the size, you always used to do that manually by increasing or decreasing the font size. Now, we can do it easily while holding the control key and scrolling your mouse wheel. Let's see how it works. Let me open an existing project. It's getting loaded. Now, let me open a code file. Yes. Let me hold the control key and scroll the mouse wheel. You can see here the size of the text is getting zoomed in or zoomed out. This is a really useful feature when you are doing a presentation and when you want to show the code to audience. Also, one important thing is this is also a WPF functionality. When you actually zoom in or zoom out, the font size gets increased or decreased but doesn't get pixelated like a digital zoom. I don't know how much of a use it is for you, but for me it's definitely useful. When I work for long hours, at the end of the day I just want my eye to relax, so I use it quite often. You can also zoom by using Ctrl plus greater than symbol and Ctrl plus less than symbol on the keyboard. This is for the guys who don't have a mouse which is having a scroll wheel. This feature was available in MS Office till now, but not in any previous version of Visual Studio. Coming back, next, docking visuals. Docking functionality is the one which is most often discussed by the developers. Microsoft has always made an attempt in improving the docking functionality. In Visual Studio 2010, we have the visuals for docking. Just like a preview or an indicator for the docking, a visual is shown indicating where the window would be docked. Let's see it working now. Let me drag this Solution Explorer window. When I'm trying to dock, you can see here there is a transparent visual coming up indicating where the window gets docked. I can see the visual when I drag to any corner. This may not be very useful and a very important feature, but nice to know that we have a feature like this. What's next? Generate from usage. Usually it goes like this. We first think of what code to write, in what order to write them, and then create classes and necessary properties, then start using them. In other way, maybe few guys want to write code as and when they get some idea, and then they want to create the classes and properties at the end. Visual Studio 2010 has a feature for them. At the end, the classes and properties are created automatically by the Visual Studio. VS 2010 is smart enough to recognize and create the properties for you based on your usage. This feature is called Generate from Usage. You'll understand it only when you see it live. Let me create a small console application. Okay, it's done. I'll add some code now. I'll first create an employee object. Employee emp1 equals new employee. Well, you know what? There is no employee class in this project at all. Now, if I hover my mouse over the warning and click on it, it gives an option, generate class for employee. Let me try clicking on that. Okay. Hey, cool. The employee class automatically got created by Visual Studio. A class file is added to the project and inside that we have a class. Was that interesting? No, not yet. Let me add two properties. emp1.name equals Anil. emp1.age equals 29. Okay. Let me hover the mouse over the properties and click on it. it again shows two options. Let me create a property. Okay. Let me call a method emp1.sayHello of 10. Okay, it's done. Now, let's see the employee class. Well, you see there are two properties created for you and even a method. Visual Studio is making sure here that you write some code inside this function now or in near future. And an interesting thing is that even the data type has been defined correctly by the Visual Studio. Was that interesting now? Believe me, not yet. Let me delete the existing code and write new. Company CMPR equals new company. Well, this time let me create a type. Hover the mouse over the name, click on that, select create a type. A new window is opened. I can generate a new type now by selecting the access level. Access levels can be default, public, or internal. The type can be a class, struct, interface, or even an enum. You can create this type in the same project, or you may want to create it in a different project as well. In my case, I don't have a different project, but if you select a different project and create the type in that project, it automatically adds a reference to the current project as well. One more interesting thing here is we can create the types in new files or we can add it to the existing files. Looks mostly like in future Microsoft will write all the code and developers will have no job. I was just kidding anyway. Okay, that's not all. Let's go back and see what other things we have in Visual Studio 2010. Highlighting references. Well, this is a small feature but can be of great use in writing the code. We create lot of objects, declare lot of variables. But how do we identify the places where we have referred those objects? We have this feature too. Just click on the variable, it will show you the references. Here we go. Let me first write some code. Now, let me click on the variable. You see the references are being highlighted automatically. This works for global variables too. And this also works when you highlight a method call of the object. It highlights the methods in the other open classes also. This feature is really cool. Next. Navigate to search. As the name suggests, Visual Studio 2010 has an improvement when it comes to navigating the code. You can use Control and comma to open up the Navigate to window. You can enter the search terms there to find a method, class, or even the file, and you can find the results which matches your criteria right there. One small thing to remember is, if you write the method names in camel case, you can even search the methods in this window using the abbreviations. Say, if your method name is sayHello, then you can just type SH. Search will be performed automatically and the results will be shown there itself. You can double click on the result to navigate to it. A beautiful feature here is that, after navigating, If you think you want to go back to where you were earlier, you can just hit Ctrl and minus. I believe most of the times you would like to use this in our projects, as we would be working with large number of classes and methods, and traditional search doesn't really satisfy our search requirement. Let's see it working. Let me hit the Ctrl plus comma. Okay, you see the Navigate To window here. Let me type Say Hello. Note that it searched the match. Yes, let me double click on the result to open it. Okay, it navigated correctly. Now I want to go back to where I was before doing this search. No problem, I will enter Ctrl and minus. Here we go. Yeah, let me bring the Navigate To window back. Now this time let me enter only SH. Yes, even now the abbreviation search works. I have given the method Say Hello in camel case. Just note that, well, I think now you are convinced that VS 2010 is brilliant. Let's see some more features. Box selection got better. I bet most of you know what a box selection is. Just hold the Alt key on your keyboard and try to select a region of code in Visual Studio. It works. Not necessarily you have to select from the beginning till the end. Well, this feature was there in Visual Studio 2008. Let's see it live. What we can do here is, I can make a zero width selection by holding the Alt key. Now, see the fun. I will type something. The whole block is written. Well, take some time and play with it. You can even paste content into the box from another box selection in the way you always wanted earlier. Let's not take time here. Let's move on. IntelliSense with Sense. We know that IntelliSense is one of the best friend for developers. Even today when I talk to developers, they say without IntelliSense it is almost impossible for them to write any code. IntelliSense is always useful, but we had a small missing feature earlier. What it is? Say for example you wanted to use IntelliSense to find a method, but if that method name is short and if it is part of some other long method name, it would really be difficult for you to continue with the short name you wanted to write. You would dismiss the IntelliSense and start writing the code once again. This is no more required. A new mode of IntelliSense is available with VS 2010, that we call it as consume first mode. Let me show the code. Let's declare a new object, employee emp1 equals new employee. Now I want to call a method called get. See now, as in when I type get, if I open the brackets, it automatically adds a different method, get hash code, which I don't want that. So how do we go ahead? Now let's try this in a different way. Hit Ctrl Alt space bar. Now IntelliSense mode is changed to suggestion mode. Let us try doing the same thing now. emp1.get, I open the brackets and I am able to close the bracket as well. Yes, it works. You can keep toggling the IntelliSense mode to normal or suggestion based on your requirements. Now, intelligence will never force you to call a method of its choice. Cool, right? What's next? Label search and export breakpoints. Now, you can label your breakpoints. You can search the breakpoints using the labels you provide. You can even export the breakpoints and import them. Let's see how it works. Let me write some code here. Let me put few breakpoints. Now, I'll bring the breakpoint window up. I can select a breakpoint here, right click on it and label it. In this example, let me give a name. Now, I can also do a search on breakpoints with a keyword. When you write some code today evening and debug it partially, tomorrow morning when you come back, you can search the breakpoint and continue debugging from that point onwards. You can also export the breakpoints. Let me try that. Now, you saw that I exported a breakpoint to XML file. Okay, I'll delete all the breakpoints now. Let me import the one which I exported just now. Yes, it works. A key thing to remember here is breakpoints works by line number. So, if you delete few lines of code after exporting breakpoints, again if you import it back, you will see breakpoints on the wrong lines. Be careful. Floating tips. I'm sure you will love this feature. In simple terms, earlier versions of Visual Studio used to show the value of the variables in debugging mode when you hovered your mouse on those variables. The enhancements now are you can actually pin those tips and you can even drag them. Here we go. Let me write a for loop for int I equals 0, I less than 10, I plus plus. Let me close this. Let me open int j equals I. Let me close the bracket. Now, I will add a breakpoint and run the program. Let me see the value of I. Okay. Now, I will pin it. Yes, here we go. Let me see the value of j. Okay, I'll pin that too. When I continue debugging, see the value of I and j. It's getting changed, right? I can even drag them to the place I want. This can really save a lot of time when you are stuck debugging your code within many for loops. Well, this is one of my favorite features also. I do use a lot of for loops. Now, call hierarchy window. Most often, you want to know what calls are your methods doing and also what methods are calling your method. Till now, we did not had any feature to help us with this problem. We used to search the method names and do lot of things. Microsoft understood our concern and gave a call hierarchy window. I'll show it, but remember this works for C# only. VB.NET guys, I'm really sorry. Wait for a few next releases. You may get these features soon. Now, you can hit Ctrl Alt K to see the call hierarchy window. Let me write a few small methods and call it from main. When I hit Ctrl+Alt+K, I see the hierarchy window. It shows what methods I am calling inside this method and also what methods are calling my method, both. I am sure when you have many projects and lot of code, you will definitely like this feature. Let's go back and see what we have next. Using statements can be sorted and deleted. What it means? This is again a C# only feature. It gives you an ability to sort the namespaces added in the alphabetical order. Also, we have a feature which enables you to remove the unused using statements from code. Let's see this last one. Let me first change the order of namespaces. Looks like we have a proper alphabetically order ones here. Okay. Now, select all of them. Let me right click and select Organize Usings. And then select Sort Usings. You saw that? The namespaces got sorted automatically. Now, let us try removing the unused ones. Right click again, Organize Usings, select Remove. Yes, it removed all of them. I think I didn't use any in my project. Okay, that's all we have for now in this session. Hopefully all these new features make sense to you. We shall look into some other features of Visual Studio for client side and web project development in near future. Thank you.